Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to be showing you some tips and tricks that can help you while playing with the Feed the Beast mod pack. Now the main thing that I want to cover in this video is the NEI, or Not Enough Items mod. Now most of you guys know kind of what this mod does. It lets you see recipes and stuff like that, but a lot of people don't quite know how to use all the features of it, and I think it's really important that you guys understand how this mod works as well as how to use it. It'll make you a better player overall, and it'll make it a lot simpler for you. Now the first thing that a lot of people are going to be needing to do is find recipes for items. Now you can look through all these pages. I happen to have 30, but depending on your resolution you have may have more or less pages. But the first thing you might be wanting to do is look up recipes. Now it's really easy to just go find a page, you know, find an item and then click on it and then find out, you know, the recipes for different items. All you do is click to find recipes, right? There's a couple other ways to do that. If you want to find the recipe for a nuke, for example, you can hit the R key, and that will show you the recipe for the nuke. You can hit the R key on any item, and that's the same as clicking on it, but it's really helpful if you have an item in your inventory, like if I have dirt. If I have dirt and I don't want to find dirt in here, I can hit the R key to find the recipe for dirt, for example, which there actually are recipes, which is surprising. So there's that. Now you can also hit the U key on your keyboard, which is the same as right clicking. So like, for example, if I right click on, let me find an item that I know is right clickable. Okay, if I right click on a diamond, it will show me all of the uses of diamonds in every crafting recipe that it exists in. So any crafting recipe that uses a diamond will show up when you right click on a diamond. The same thing can be done if you hover over an item and hit the U key, which, and that'll also show you the uses basically. So the U stands for uses and R stands for recipe. So if you remember those two, when you're hovering over an item, those two keys will show you the use or recipe of that item respectively. Now the next thing that I want to go over is this search bar. Now there's a couple things, obviously people know you can search diamond, right? And it will show up anything kind of related to what you searched for. So if I search for block, obviously anything with block in the name is going to come up. So it's basically a global search through any of the item names. What a lot of people don't know is you can clear it really easily. So for example, if I looked up lapis lazuli block, if I could spell, that would be amazing. You'll see I find it, yeah, that's cool, but now what if I need to learn how to make, I don't know, a compressor, right? Well, then I'm going to go here and I'm going to hit my backspace key over and over, and it's really frustrating when people do that. So instead of going down here and using your backspace key, all you have to do is right click on the search box and all the text in it gets cleared. So I can type whatever I want in here, and instead of having to backspace it, I just right click and I'm ready to go again. So that's really useful. Now the other thing that a lot of people do that really frustrates me is if you go in here and you double click, you'll see the search bar turns like a yellowish color. I guess that is yellow. I always call it gold, but I guess it's yellow. You'll see right now it's doing nothing, but as soon as I start typing, it's going to black out my inventory. And the reason it does this is because it's actually searching my inventory for any item that contains these letters, right? So if I put a D in there, well, dirt has a D beginning the word, right? So dirt is actually highlighted. And this is really helpful for helping you look through a chest or find things that you know are in a chest, but you just can't see them because you're blind. I know I have that problem. So you can double click to search for items, but most of the time it's really frustrating. So just double click to get rid of the darkness around all of your items, because a lot of people seem to like accidentally double click and then they just leave it like that. They're just, you know, whatever, it's just a bug. It's not a bug, it's actually there on purpose. So just keep that in mind. You can right click and you can double click that search bar. Very important stuff. The only other thing that I really want to show you guys about this NEI or Not Enough Items is when you click on options, you can actually switch this into what is known as cheat mode, and it allows you to cheat. Now obviously this isn't going to work on a server, but I can spawn myself in, you know, whatever I want, right? So I can use cheat mode and it's, yeah, it's available to you. Cheat mode also lets you like heal yourself and turn on magnet mode, which is actually pretty cool. You can, if you turn on magnet mode, like you saw that seed was pretty far from me. So if I walk you'll see it kind of pops right into my inventory, which is pretty neat. But yeah, it's mainly for like creative, like it's like a survival creative, where like this is creative mode plus, where you know you've got regular creative mode, which has this little inventory, but that disables this NEI area, and I really like NEI, so you can do creative mode plus, which allows you to spawn in items and have a huge inventory, which is really nice. But yeah, that's basically it for NEI. I'm going to go ahead and turn this off and switch it back into recipe mode. And I'm going to go ahead and cover the next thing that I it's just kind of like a personal pet peeve more than anything. A lot of people have in here, they have this sort key set to the R key. Oops. What the hell? R? Done. Okay, so they have it set to the R key, so anytime they're typing in here, this is me typing, and then they start typing R's, right? Obviously, they're not typing R's in a row like this, but they would type an R and it makes a clicking sound. That clicking sound is actually NEI, or not NEI, this is actually another mod called Inventory Tweaks, and it actually, every time you hit the R key, it sorts your inventory. So let me just clear this out. Let me spawn a couple scrap boxes. All right, I think this will demonstrate what I'm trying to talk about. So my inventory is full of crap right now, right? So if I hit the R key, oh, it's all sorted. And it's sorted kind of by item ID. I don't quite know. It almost is sorted by item ID, but then it almost isn't. So I don't quite understand how it works, but it sorts your inventory when you hit the R key. You can trust me on that. Now, it's just really frustrating that it makes the clicking sound, and it's going to sort your inventory anytime you hit the R key. So the way to fix this is to hit this little three dots here inside your inventory, hit on your sort key, and I tend to use the grave key. You can use any key you want. Generally, it's better not to use a key that you're going to be typing with. The grave key is perfect for that. I don't think I've ever used it in my life. So use that, and you're perfect. There's a couple other options in here which are nice to mess with, but honestly, just leave it default. Some people, like for me, I generally turn off the auto refill. It's nice, but most of the time it just frustrates me more than anything. So I generally turn off my sort key, turn off the auto refill. Now, if you still do want to sort, you can always quick click that sort key, or if you have a scroll wheel on your mouse, you can click that in, and that will end up sorting your inventory too. So you still have options to sort your inventory, but it's just better not to use the options that it recommends. So hopefully that made sense to you. And there's only a couple more things that I want to talk about. Actually, I think there's only one more thing that I want to talk about. So, god damn it. All these items flying around because I've got my whatever mode on. All right, so I'm just going to break this furnace so I can show you. There we go. So I've got this furnace here, right? And so normally when you right-click, like for example, if I'm like, oh, I want to put a block on here. I can't put a block on my bat box because the bat box has an inventory. So you open the inventory instead of placing a block. Well, in the mods, most of the modded items, if you hold your crouch key and right-click the item, you'll actually be able to place an item. Rather than opening that inventory. Now, this doesn't work for vanilla items. You'll see I'm crouching, and I open the furnace interface. But you can do it for most of the modded items. As far as I know, all of them will work, but I haven't personally tested it. In my experience, they've all worked, so I haven't found one that hasn't, but it's really useful to know. So, like, when you're trying to lay these wires or whatever, you don't have to have a block to place them on. It's really useful, and just feel like people should know that. All right, the one last thing that I wanted to show you is there's a feature that a lot of people don't know about, and that is that you can search for a recipe. So say I'm in this crafting table. Now this only works in a crafting table. It doesn't work otherwise, as far as I know. I could be wrong about this, but you have to be in a crafting table basically. And so say I want to search up how to make a furnace. There we go. So there's a furnace. So I want to know the recipe. Oh, it's cobblestone. Well, maybe I don't have enough memory in my brain to remember that cobblestone is 8 cobble around an empty space. So, or furnace rather, is 8 cobble around an empty space. So I can hit this question mark key and it highlights it in my crafting table. So I can be like, oh, cobblestone around an empty space like this. Now this isn't really helpful for furnaces, obviously, but for more complicated recipe, like say I wanted to make the rotary macerator. or macerator, whichever you like to say, I can find the recipe for that. And then if I'm in my crafting table, I can find the recipe for it and have it show me where to put items, right? So it's really useful for that. And I definitely recommend you check that out. But anyway, that's going to wrap up my video here. Hopefully you enjoyed these tips. Hopefully they helped you out. If they did help you out, be sure to share this video with people you think it might help out as well. Also, if you enjoyed the video, go ahead and leave a rating. And until next time, I will see you guys later.